It feels like everyone seems to know about Gwangjang Market thanks to the Netflix street food series. But maybe you want to go somewhere less crowded, where you can try mung bean pancakes and Susuheukmihottel. Stay tuned to find out where this place is. Yes, they also have rice cakes. Hope you enjoy this episode of 10 Days in Seoul with Miss Mina and Mommy O.
안녕 친구!
Today, Mommy O and I, we're going to be checking out
중부 건어물 시장, in short, Jungbu Market. As soon as we enter from gate 1, we encounter piles of dried squid and a stall making Susuheukmihottel, sorghum black rice pancakes. Each one is 1,000 won, about 80 cents US.
This stall also sells donuts over there, fried donuts.
We've tried hotteok many times, but I do believe it's the first time we're trying the sorghum black rice kind.
It's sticky, chewy.
The filling is hot and drippy. Try not to burn your tongue.
It's like japjare. It looks like a mouth, and there's a bunch of teeth.
Mommy O made a good point. Some hotteok we've had, it's like deep fried. This one is pan fried. So it's a cleaner hotteok.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, you're right. It's not too oily.
Oh, it warms my heart to see elders hold hands like this. Basketfuls of dried jujube. These are so good sliced on pingsu. Like this one on the top. Yum. Under the gate 2 signage, there is another street food stall. The vendor makes Susubukumi, also contains sorghum.
The stall also sells fish cake. First she's putting on her gloves. Put some oil, spread it around. Oh, it looks like she has some dough ready. Oh, she pushes it down. Kind of like the hotteok. Wow, it almost looks like meat.
She slides and unpeels them from sticking to the cooking surface. A spoonful of red bean paste is placed on one side, not in the center, but more to her left. This allows each Susubukumi to be folded in half.
Susubukumi입니다. 오래 전통.
감사합니다. The street food vendor was so friendly, and she even let us film her make the whole thing. Sometimes street food vendors don't like it when you film how they're making the food. So you know like how she was making it? It almost looked like she was making hotteok, but it's a little different because here she was pushing with the round thing and then she put the filling inside.
With hotteok, you enclose the filling first, then flatten and fry.
Okay, so here's the difference between this and the hotteok. The hotteok, the skin was thinner. This one, it's more fleshy. And then here we have the red bean paste inside.
Texture가 little gritty.
Oh, the texture is a little gritty.
Mm-hmm.
I love the filling though. The filling is not as sweet as the hotteok. The hotteok filling is like super liquidy and super sweet.
아까 먹은 수수흑미호떡은 수수보다 쌀이 많이 들어갔어. 그래서 쫄깃쫄깃해. 근데 이거는 수수가 더 많이 들어간 거야. 원래 수수부꾸미는 수수만 갖고 하거든. 근데 얘네들이 너무 잘 달라붙어서 만들기가 힘들어.
Do you prefer the hotteok or this one? Yeah, me too. I'm seeing a lot of dried goods here, dried seafood, dried seaweed. We're looking for almonds because we just ran out. We found one location. How much is it though? All right, so one of these bags is 12,000 won and we're gonna get it. We're gonna bring this with us to the Philippines. We'll probably finish it there. There's also dried fruit, dried lotus, noodles. Wow, that's a party in there.
Wow.
Dried strawberry. That's actually really good. That's sweeter than a typical strawberry. Oh, what is that? Healthy and actually delicious. It's savory.
Freezing dried fig.
Dude, check it out. This is a freeze-dried fig. I've had dried fig many times before, but not like this. That one's a little weird, but it is sweet and tasty in the inside. It's still a little weird. I recommend the strawberry more. Have you ever had a freeze-dried todok? It started off savory and then it ended with a bitterness and the bitterness just stays with you. It's clingy. They do alteration here and she's eating lunch by her sewing machine.
And then there's this overflowing beer sculpture with fish and squid popping out.
So this is where it came down from and we are gonna make a left. Oh, they have rice cakes.
Ooh la la. Temptations in abundance.
What's interesting, there are two donut shops at the end of the street right next to each other.
competing. Well, I don't know their full story, but the gentleman was like, come to our shop.
Currently, I'm smelling sesame oil, chili powder, and then now I'm smelling seafood. Shall we go through this way? That looks interesting. 안녕하세요. All right, we found a Bindaetteok shop.
Oh, nice. She's making a fresh Bindaetteok.
Oh, just listen to it sizzle when she first puts it on.
The Bindaetteok is cut into smaller pieces. Those white strands, they're mung bean sprouts. Each Bindaetteok is 3,000 won. By the way, on the menu, Bindaetteok is referred to as Nokdujeon. The vendor also makes Puchujeon, chive pancakes.
Outside is nice and crispy.
This is more traditional way than the other one in Gwangjang Shijang. It's better.
Gwangjang Shijang might be more famous, but that doesn't mean they have the best of everything. So Mamio likes the Jungbu Shijang Bindaetteok more.
The mung bean pancake comes with a dipping sauce made of soy sauce and scallion. We also get a side of pickled onion, radish, and cabbage.
이게 정말 멍빈 그게 맛이 나잖아. 멍빈하고 멍빈 스프라운 맛이 나잖아.
The outside is a little crispy because of the way it was cooked. And then the inside is crunchy because of the sprouts.
You can put a piece of pickled cabbage on the savory pancake.
Now the Nokdu Bindaetteok, it's warm, it's dense. The sauce and the pickled veggies, that brings a freshness and also a lot of flavor.
여기 고추가 들어가서 매워. 하나 먹어볼까?
Spicy?
I'm okay.
Oh, you're okay. This stall, they also sell omuk, the fish cakes. But because the weather is warmer now, she doesn't sell it currently. It's in the colder months, you'll see it here. Double chopstick action.
This stall is near the Anchovy Alley sign. For round three, we are drawn to a big circular glowing sign that reads chuk. Porridge. Let us try the Patkalguksu. Everything on the menu is under 6,000 won.
We're gonna wait 7 to 8 minutes for it to be prepared.
The vendor also makes bibimbap.
Yo, we just learned that the vendor here has been making this for 40 years. She was selling at another location though.
The Patkalguksu has arrived. It contains red beans, noodles, and more noodles.
We made a baby bowl out of the mommy bowl. Oh, that's hot. It has a neutral flavor. There was no like extra sugar or anything added.
Oh, she just made konggu and she gave us a sample.
I thought it was gonna be warm. It's like room temperature. It's very bubbly, very foamy. Yeah, I know, it's super cool. I like it. Turns out the vendor also used sesame and peanut.
Oodles of noodles, get ready to say toodles. Just notice there are seats inside the shop.
I made a hot mess on my leg. So it's common that they give you the kimchi with patchouli. For me, red bean is synonymous with dessert, so I'd rather eat something like sweet with it.
We gave the kimchi to our neighbor because that's a lot for us.
Fresh and spicy! I want to yell that out. Spicy.
This, I believe, will be considered vegan and vegetarian. Look at that ginseng, looks so sexy.
저기 ginseng이 여자 몸처럼 그렇게 다리 있고 섹시하게 생긴 ginseng이 더 효과가 많대.
Turns out Jungbu Market is next to yet another traditional market called Bangsan Shijang, which is home to baking and craft materials, amongst other things, such as flooring.
Alright, we're taking a taxi back to our Airbnb, and then it's almost 2 right now. At 3, we have a photo shoot. Do you prefer Gwangjang Shijang or the one we went to today? Jungbu Shijang.
I like Jungbu Shijang.
It's not crowded. So if you have only one market to visit, I recommend Gwangjang Shijang because there's so much to eat and there's like so many vendors to choose from. But if you are not big on crowds, you could just swing by next door. Or let's say you go to Gwangjang Shijang, and there's too many people, you can't handle it, you can just walk over to the Jungbu Shijang. What's up, Roy? It's our first time working together.
Yes.
I love your work. So right now we are at Gwangjang Market. We did some photo shooting with these noodles, kalguksu. Mamio and I were here yesterday, yeah. And we filmed here at this very stall. And you know what? It's more delicious today.
Yeah.
Yesterday we were eating all kinds of food, but we're eating this on a clean palate without having other food, so we could really feel more of the flavor today. Before you eat bindaetteok or anything else, I recommend you come here first. So I'm meeting up with Dylan,
who has restful sleep.
Before we came here, he was like, oh, let's go to a bar on the rooftop with a waterfall. What kind of waterfall? I thought it was gonna be like a real waterfall, water sounds, zen, but look.
There it is.
Look at this waterfall.
It's a traditional Korean waterfall.
Dude, you cracked me up. Shindoshi, this place is called Shindoshi. And Roy is here too, but he's getting second round.
And that concludes day six. In the next episode of 10 Days in Seoul, we have a special guest, Mr. Sweet Potato with a mountain of ice cream and honeycomb. And then this magical cheesy encounter ensues.
Remember to subscribe and hit that notification bell. For food and travel around the world, check out my other channel, Miss Mina. 안녕, 친구!
Thank you, Mommy-o, for breakfast. Veggies with egg, 2 Brazil nuts, mushroom. Wow, I've never seen cars like this in Korea until I got to this area.
Tuk-tuk!
Yeah, it looks like tuk-tuk. Wow, look at all those boxes. Very teeny cuttlefish. Do you see that? Thinner than my pinky. Sorry guys, lots of motorcycles coming and going. This market was open since 1957.
Susubukumi, 요거 살짝 뒤에서
And each one is 1001. There may be more, but we passed by two shops that freshly press sesame oil. A customer just came by and she was like, oh, the potato jeon is so good. I'm wondering if should we try it? Right before we came here, there was no one else, huh? Right now, the stall is covered with customers. 1, 2, 7. This market has more breathing space than Gwangjang Shijang. Gwangjang Shijang was packed, even if it was weekday.
Gwangjang Shijang just across the street.
Yeah, Gwangjang Shijang is like right over there. Super close, walking distance.